So, you want to join 3D printed parts, and you probably already know that sometimes glue is just not enough. That is why today I will teach you step by step how to design a custom joint for any of your models. We will use the technique known to carpenters for centuries. This basic and yet effective joint consists of a protruding tongue called tenon and a fitting hole, a mortise. This joint comes in many shapes and sizes, and it does have quite a few appliances in 3D printing. To name a few, it's a great solution to fit the pieces together perfectly, as it locks the 3D printed parts in place. There's just no room to wiggle around, as long as your tenon has corners. After all, cylinders allow for rotation, that's why I don't recommend using them. Another advantage is that it increases the area of contact surface, which is very important when you glue the parts together. The more surface in contact, the stronger the bond is. This joint is even more effective against the forces parallel to the surface. Obviously, there is an added value coming from the durability of PLA. Like in this example, where the glue is yet to be applied. Now, let me explain how to design a custom joint. Open a new Blender file and import your model. We're going to use the built-in add-on called Bool Tool, and to do so, go to Edit, Preferences, and type in Bool. Mark it as active and save the preferences. To begin with, we need to have our model cut into separated pieces. If you wonder how to do that, I have already made a dedicated tutorial on dividing 3D models for printing. You can find it here. Now, it is very important to place the parts in the right position, so assemble the model just like if it's already been printed. It's way easier to do that once you turn on snapping, and then switch to vertex. Now you can just move the parts along the axis and snap them into the correct position. Next, click Shift and A to add new mesh. Any shape will work, but I recommend starting with a cube. This object will become our joint in a few minutes. Now, select one of the parts and click H to temporarily hide it. You can always bring it back with this little icon. This is the time to find a perfect spot for our tenon. Place it on a surface that will be connected to the other part, and adjust the scale or edit the shape, if you want to. Now, the tongue is supposed to stick out of the first part for about a half of its length. You can either eyeball it while moving the part, or if you want to be precise, click N to see the properties of the selected mesh. Now, when we know its size, we can snap it to the surface using our little magnet, and then manually move it further for the half of its length. Remember, you can always create more joints if you want to. Simply select the object, click Shift D, and move the new tongue along the axis. If you uncover the hidden elements, you should find the tenon to be fully covered by both parts of the model. Select the shaft and copy it once by using Shift D command. Don't move it anywhere, just click Escape to leave the copy in the same spot. While holding Shift, select the tongue first and then the visible part of your 3D model in that exact order. Click Ctrl Shift B and choose Difference. This will cut a hole in the model, but you may not see it since there is another tongue here that we copied earlier. Next, uncover the second part of the model and hide the first one. This part will hold the tenon, but before that, we have to adjust it. We must achieve a bit of clearance, so the parts can fit each other without friction. I usually scale down the tongue to 95 or 97%, which may not be the most accurate method, but it hasn't failed me so far. For those of you who want precise data, the 0.2 mm clearance should work ideally. Using Shift, select both visible parts, click Ctrl Shift B and pick Union. The tongue is now fixed to the surface. Turn on visibility for both parts and you're good to go. Select the first part, go to File Export, STL, and click on Selection Only. The same goes for the other half of the model. Using this method, you can connect any 3D printed parts, but if you're looking for more advanced ways of prototyping your ideas, you may be interested in the sponsor of this video. PCBWay is one of the biggest prototype manufacturers in the world. They offer a variety of services like 3D printing with FDM, SLA, SLS, and others, which can give you a huge advantage with more advanced projects. Thanks to their intuitive system, you can get a quote for any processing by simply following the questionnaire. They also specialize in services like CNC machining, injection molding, laser cutting, and many more, including electronics, like custom printed circuit boards. The link is in the description. And that's it for the video. Let me know if you enjoyed the tutorial and what should I cover next time. Thanks!